Black soldier fly farming is changing the game in sustainable agriculture. In this video, I'll show you how to build a simple, efficient, BSF structure from scratch. This setup is perfect for both beginners and small-scale farmers. I'll walk you through each step to help you succeed. Let's get started. Your BSF journey begins now. An ideal structure should be rain-proof, rodent-proof, and well-ventilated. And also in terms of insects, it should be free from insects and able to maintain or retain maximum moisture. And the structure should be able to receive enough light during the day. The structure should also be well secure all the time, easily accessible, and have a well-drained ground. The ideal condition of the structure should have a temperature of 25 to 35 degrees centigrade and moisture of 50% with light intensity of about 60%. To construct a BSF house measuring approximately 5 meters long, 3 meters wide and 2 meters high, you require nails of 2 inches, quantity of 2 kg. Nails of 3 inches require 3 kg and nails of 4 inches require 3 kg. Also, you require polythene paper, preferable yellow or green in color, 200 microns, 50 of them or 50 square meter, and also an insect net around 35 meter square, and also breeding site and ventilation area you require. And also timber of 3 inch by 2 inch, each measuring 7 feet long, you require 33 pieces of them or in number. And timber of 2 inch by 2 inch, you require 22. Posts of 7 feet long, we require only 10 of them in numbers. Also, we require a padlock, you require a binding tape, quantity number of 1, binding wire, hygrometer for measuring humidity, and round plastic basins that are used for either feeding or putting the BSF eggs. You require around 6 of them. When designing a black soldier fly rearing structure, you can break it down into several key sections to ensure proper functioning. Each section plays a crucial role in supporting life cycle of the flies, from larva rearing to egg collection and adult breeding. Here are the main sections to consider for your BSF structure. The first section is feeding and larva rearing area, and the purpose of this section is where the larva are raised on organic waste such as food scrap, manure, or agricultural byproducts. So the design of it, we have the containers or a tray, use shallow bins or tray, preferable food graded with drainage hole to avoid waterlogging. Organic waste layer, so the layers layer the bins with organic waste materials, food for larva. And also in this section, we ensure that there is ventilation to ensure there is proper flow of air to allow oxygen to circulate, so that we can prevent mold growth. And another section, which is breeding or adult fly area. The purpose of this section is to house an adult BSF for mating and egg laying. So the design of it, we have the breeding chamber that is a separate enclosed area with mesh walls where adult can fly freely, stay cool and mate. Another part is the egg laying surface, provide a flat surface such as mesh or cardboard for females to lay their eggs. And in this section, may ensure that the light and temperatures are very preferable or ideal, because BSF prefer dark and warm environment for egg laying. So keep the area shaded and maintain temperatures as mentioned earlier. Another section is the pupate area. So the purpose of this area is to place the larva to pupate before transforming into adult flies. So the design of it is we have the migration tray or area. Once larvae reach maturity, they move towards a designated area to pupate. You can create a slope or use container with an inclined surface to guide the larva into pupation zone. Materials in this area, we normally use the surface, ensure the surface is dry to encourage pupation. You can also add dry organic material like sawdust or rice husk to help larva into transition. Another important section is harvesting and collection area. The purpose of this section is to collect larva for use in various applications such as animal feed or composting. So the design of it is to have a sloped harvesting tray that creates an inclined harvesting surface or bin to collect manure larvae that have migrated downward. So we have also collection bins. Use a separate container to collect harvested larvae. Ensure it's clean and kept away from contaminants. And then the bins should be made accessible for manual collection or cleaning. Waste management and drainage section. This purpose of it is to manage the waste and excess moisture, preventing the buildup of mold or pests. So under designing this section, ensure that the draining system in each section, especially the feeding area, has drain system for excess moisture. This can be as simple as tray with small hole or more advanced water drainage system. Waste removal, regularly remove leftover material to keep the area clean and also scent or odor free. You can have a section which is for the environmental control. So the purpose of this section is to maintain optimal temperature, humidity and airflow for the BSF colony. So the design in the environmental control section, we have thermometer and hygrometer. These tools are kept here to monitor temperature and humidity level within the optimal range. And also in this section, you can have a ventilation system. Proper airflow is crucial to prevent mold growth and ensure healthy BSF development. We can have mesh fans or small ventilation holes that can aid in maintaining airflow. Each section of your BSF structure is designed to support a specific stage in the BSF life cycle, ensuring health, growth, and sustainable production. This setup helps you optimize efficiency while managing organic waste and producing valuable products like larvae, compost, and biogas. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this guide on building a black soldier fly rearing structure helpful and inspiring. If you are ready to start your own sustainable BSF system, make sure to follow these steps we covered today. If you have any question or you want to share your progress, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on more tips and tricks for sustainable farming. See you in the next video.